have to do is go to Tools, CLIU, Instantiate or Destroy CLIU. And here it is. You can also change the settings a bit to customize your experience. So let's hit the play button. And to see CLIU, you have to open it on this button on the corner or just play the ampersand button on your keyboard. To start, let's see the help tooltip and see that we have a few suggestions of what to do next to learn how to use CLIU. Let's say help, press enter, and see that we have the core commands, the commands that compose the brain of CLIU. But the interesting and powerful part is modules. If you type modules, or just M to be faster in this case, you will see all the modules that are currently running. OBJ for object, pprefs for player prefs, and so on. I can say help or just H, pprefs, and it will list all the commands of this module, pprefs. Let's try getInt and score, for example. It shows 0 because I don't have anything stored on this score here, on player prefs. So let's set int score and 500. And if I press the up arrow key twice, it will get me the previous command. And here it is, 500. CLIU becomes really useful when you are trying to iterate, debug, or test features of your game in a very flexible way. I personally tested it with programmers and designers to huge success. It gave us a lot of speed to develop faster and test our game with the building modules and custom modules to spawn stages, check for bugs, and much more. And as a final note, CLIU is a free open source project, which means you can change its code to help the community or for your own needs. I hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching.